Welcome to Fort Jennings High School for the 2018 Putnam County Band and Choir Concert. I am Gary Herman, this is Melissa Basinger. We are the curriculum coordinators for the Putnam County Educational Service Center. Before we begin, I would like to extend our sincere gratitude to Fort Jennings Schools, their teachers, administration, and music boosters for their generous support and hospitality. Thank yous include Superintendent High School Principal Mr. Nick Langhouse, Band and Choir Director Mr. Dan Basinger, Art Instructor Mrs. Joy Noriega, and Elementary Principal Mr. Matt Dubay. Every year, we move this festival to another district. It takes a lot of logistical planning, so their help and flexibility to facilitate this event is greatly appreciated. I know that none of you came here today to listen to either Melissa or I talk, but we do have some very crucial awards and recognition, so please bear with us for a few minutes here at the beginning. This concert represents one portion of the 5th annual Putnam County Arts Festival. The purpose of this festival is to dedicate an entire afternoon to bringing awareness to the outstanding talents of Putnam County students have, not only in the performing arts, but in the visual arts as well. Speaking of the visual arts, we would like to take a few minutes here to recognize some of our outstanding artists as well as their instructors. It is beneficial to have these students and teachers available at the art show to discuss and present their pieces, so we don't want to pull them away too long, but it's also important that they receive proper recognition. It is now time to recognize those involved in the art portion of the Arts Festival. County art teachers spend Friday afternoon here at Fort Jennings setting up the display of the wonderful artwork you see. Melissa organizes and helps facilitate the art show, so I'm going to turn it over to her for those details.
Yesterday morning, a guest art judge, Mrs. Sharon King, was charged with the difficult task of evaluating all of the artwork and selecting 15 best of show pieces from the high school art pieces. Mrs. King is a retired art teacher from Columbus Grove High School. So please join me in thanking Mrs. King for the work she did in making today's art show a success. Show, you will see the best show pieces marked with purple rosettes. A tremendous amount of thought, time, and effort goes into just one piece of artwork. We have students right here in Putnam County who are exceptional artists, which is shown in all of the pieces that you will see here today. For anyone that can't be here today, we're going to try something new and do a Facebook Live of the Art Award presentation, so you might be able to view that later this afternoon. I'm now going to announce each art student and the work they created, which earned them the Best of Show honor. So students, when I recognize you, if you'll please come forward up here and stay here until we've announced everybody then. So the Best of Show Award winners, we have Liz Westrick from Miller City, New Cleveland, for the piece Wrapped Up in Harmony. McKenna Lehman from Miller City, New Cleveland, for the piece Flying Colors. From Miller City, New Cleveland, for a piece called Two-Sided. Cody Horseman from Fort Jennings for a self-portrait. Samantha Inbody from Pandora Gilboa. Different eyes see different things. Leah Baker from Continental for a piece titled Madrid. Megan Schulte from Kaleida for Finger Lickin' Good. a new dimension. Abigail Hilvers from Audeville for a piece titled Determined. Hannah Warren from Kaleida for Pineapple. Hannah Troyer from Continental. And Hannah actually has two pieces that have won awards today. One of them is titled Time of Culture, and another piece is Taste the Feeling. We have Evie Burwell from Miller City, New Cleveland for Natasha Superstar. And finally, Tess Niece from Miller City, New Cleveland, for a little teapot without a spout. And these fabulous artists here are 15 Best of Show Award winners. Let's give them a nice round of applause. Recognize the art teachers that have helped push not only these students, but all of their students to reach their full artistic potential. Without these individuals' hard work and dedication, today's art show would not be possible. The art teachers are seated over here to my left, and when I announce them, I'm going to ask them to stand up to be recognized, and we can hold our applause to the end. From Columbus Grove, we have Sarah Ricker and Megan Rhodes. From Continental, Jennifer Hawks. Fort Jennings, Joy Noriega. Kaleida, Steve Myers. Lipsick, Rachel Lionhouse and Christine Christman. Miller City, Alicia Verhoff. Ottawa Glandorf, Laura Myers. Audeville, Kim Burt and Corey Becker. And St. Peter and Paul, Allison Siefker. We actually have one more art teacher, Mr. Mark Williams from Pandora Gilboa. And Mr. Williams will be retiring at the end of this school year. So we'd like to take a minute to recognize Mark for his 36 and a half years of service as an art teacher. When I asked the art teachers to express some of their thoughts and feelings about Mr. Williams, here are a couple of quotes that I was given. He is not only a mentor, but I also consider him one of my greatest friends. He is the reason I became an art teacher. And I'm sure others that have left PG to become art teachers would say the same thing. It is my hope that I have inspired or will inspire my students the way he has inspired me. He seems to have the answers for everything, not just art-related questions, but has the answers about life questions and issues too. He has helped me make sense of so many things. He is a listener, a very good listener. He is patient and understanding. He is a nurturer. And beyond all of these amazing attributes, he is also an amazing art teacher. His retirement will be felt not only by the PG District and community, but also by our Art Teacher Association. Mark truly listened to the students, steered them in the right direction, gave advice, taught life lessons, and made people want to be better versions of themselves. The world needs more people like Mark Williams. So congratulations, Mark, and best of luck in your next chapter of your life. And We have high school artwork in the auxiliary gym right behind us, and then junior high and elementary artwork in the hallways as you leave near the front entrance. So please take a few minutes to see the outstanding art pieces from kindergarten through 12th grade. And we appreciate you visiting our art display today.
Thank you. Thank you.